are going to see question number 5. Number 5, saying explain the following terms: a thermodynamic system, isolated system, open system, closed system, adiabatic process, isothermal process, isobaric process, and isochoric process. These are different processes that we need to explain. Let's start. A thermodynamic system is a body of matter or radiation which is confined in a space by walls of defined permeability which separate it from all its surroundings. Or in other words, it is a kind of matter or region in space that is of interest. That means that when you have a thermodynamic system, it is separated from the surroundings by walls and it has a defined permeability. That a system, it has inside the matter and the energy which can be exchanged with the surrounding. If we can see on the schematic diagram, so we can see that you have a system. It's a system and separated by the walls. These are walls in red, and outside the walls, when you go outside of the walls, that's what you call the surrounding system and the surrounding, and the system is separated by with the surrounding by walls. And these walls, that's what we call the boundaries of the system. The walls, that's what we call the boundaries of the system. As an example, if you have a gas, and the gas which is confined the cylinder constitute a system, and the boundaries of the walls of the cylinder, that's what we are calling as the boundaries. And then the region outside the cylinder, that's what you are calling the surrounding region outside the cylinder, that is what you are calling as surrounding. Of course, we have also here a piston which can increase or decrease the pressure and the volume of this gas in the cylinder. That was it. That means that when you have an isolated system, you don't have any exchange of matter and energy with the surrounding. No exchange of energy or matter with the surrounding when the system is isolated. For example, when you have a coffee in a closed when it's rated thermos, that coffee will keep hot because cannot be exchanged with cannot exchange heat with the surrounding. So it is isolated system, the heat remains there, energy remains there, energy and matter do not be exchanged with the surrounding in the isolated system. Another system is closed system. In a closed system is a system in which only energy is exchanged with the surrounding. Only energy is exchanged with the surrounding, but not matter. For example, if you put a coffee in a cup, a hot coffee in a cup, you will see that, and you cross the cup, you will see that there is an exchange of the heat with the surrounding. So the energy is exchanged with the surrounding. Only energy is exchanged with surrounding in the closed system. In open system, is a system in which both energy and matter can be exchanged with the surrounding. When you have an open system, it's a system which can exchange matter with surrounding. It can also exchange the energy of the surrounding. So, for example, you have an open cup of coffee, there is an exchange of the heat and the matter with the surrounding. Adiabatic process, it's a process in which only work is exchanged with the surrounding, only work. So there is no heat, no addition of heat nor heat is released if the is released in the surrounding. So that means that here the Q or the change in the heat is zero for adiabatic process. For example, when you have addition, when you have the air pack and you compress it using a pressure, or you expand it by decreasing the external pressure, in that case you have what you call adiabatic process, a process in which the heat does not change. The change in the heat is zero, and the system can only exchange the work with the surrounding. That is what you are referring as the adiabatic process. So the change in heat is zero in the adiabatic process. We have also isothermal process. Isothermal process is a process occurring at a constant temperature. When you have a process occurring at a constant temperature, that is isothermal process. That means that delta T, or the change in temperature, is zero in the isothermal process. The temperature remains constant. Of course, heat can be added or can be released to maintain the temperature constant. Isobaric process is a process that takes place under constant pressure. An isobaric process, you should be having a constant pressure. So the pressure is constant, that means that the change in the pressure is zero in isobaric process. In isochoric process, it's a process that takes place at constant volume. That means delta V, or change in volume, is zero. So the volume is constant. So delta V, or the change in volume, in isochoric process is zero. Let's move to question 6. Question 6 is saying that the volume of the gas increased from 3 to 9 liter. There is an increase in the volume of the gas from 3 to 9 liter at constant pressure of 4 atmosphere. Next, the heat is added to increase the pressure. So the pressure then was increased to 10 atmosphere at constant volume. So the first one, the first process was at constant pressure, and the second process, the pressure was increased at constant volume. Then finally, heat is removed to decrease the pressure and the volume back to original value. So that means that the third process removed the heat to decrease the pressure and the volume back to the original values. Then they're asking, explain how work done is calculated for the gas in a cylinder doing expansion and compression. Explain how work done is calculated, how the work done is calculated for a gas in a cylinder doing expansion and compression. That is what they're asking. Secondly, they're asking to draw a PV diagram for the process, and to calculate the total work done in this process. So the total work done in the process where the gas increased from 3 to 9 liter at 4 atmosphere, and then the pressure increased to 10 atmosphere at constant volume, and then lastly, then the heat is removed to decrease the pressure and the volume back to original values. Let's see the answer. We know that the work is defined as the force applied over a distance. So the force applied over a distance. So that means that the work done is equal to the force times the distance. Of course, we need to press the minus sign to indicate that there is a flow of work. So because the work done is done by the system. So that means minus F, which is the force times the change in the distance. We can then replace this force. We know that the force is caused by the pressure. The pressure is defined as the force per unit area. So the pressure is the force per unit area. So then from this definition of the pressure, we can get the F, which is the force. So meaning that the force is equal to the pressure times the area. Force equal to pressure times the area. So force is equal to pressure times the area. So then we can replace this F, this force, in the formula. Then we get the force is equal to pressure times the area. Then we get the work done equal to minus pressure times area. So we have replaced pressure times area in the formula, then times delta x. So if you check this A, this is the area, times dx, the change, dx in the distance, and if we take area times dx, then you get dv, the change in the volume. If you check the area times the height of delta x, so immediately you get the volume. So the pressure is equal to minus p dv, the volume. Then we know pv is equal to nRT, then is equal to this one equal minus n r delta t. So if you are having the change in temperature, so you can either calculate the work done by using the change in volume, or you calculate it by using the change in temperature. Now for the cylinder, because we asked to calculate the cylinder, so the area, the dv, we need to calculate the delta v for the volume of the cylinder. Then the volume of the cylinder we know is the area times the height, the area which is PL square times the height, then which is equal to area times the height, then delta V is equal to area times delta H, so the change in the height. Then if we can replace in the formula, then we will get the work done to minus P delta V, which is equal to minus P times area times delta H, so we are replacing the volume of the cylinder. So minus P times the area times delta H. So then when you have a system, when you have a system where there is expansion, when the system does work on the surrounding, that means the volume increase, that is expansion. Delta V here, delta V here will be positive, then the work will be negative. Then when you have a compression, or when the work is being done on the system, the volume decrease, so that means delta V will be negative, then the work is positive. Negative from dV times negative here, then you get the work which is positive. So that is how the work done is calculated. So let's go to another sub-question that we need to draw the PV diagram. So from A, from the one position to the from A to B, so we have the a system which increases the volume at constant pressure. The volume increases from 3 to 9 liter at the constant pressure of 4 atmosphere. So we move here from A to B. The volume increases from 3 atmosphere to from 3 liter to 9 liter at the pressure which is a constant of 4 atmosphere. The next step, then the heat was added to increase the pressure to 10 atmosphere. That's from B to C, we are increasing the pressure at constant volume of 9 liter, and increase the pressure to 10 atmosphere. Then lastly, we are decreasing the heat, so that we can removing the heat so that we can decrease both the volume and the pressure back to A, back to initial values. This is the PV diagram. So then the next step, we are asked to calculate the net work done, the total work done. We calculate the work done in this here, in A to B, work done in B to C, and work done in C to A. If you check from A to B, we have constant pressure but increasing the volume. We use the formula of calculating work equal to PdV. So that is formula we used. From A to B, the pressure is equal to a constant for atmosphere. Pressure is constant for atmosphere. The volume, the change in volume, it will be 9 minus 3. Then we get minus 24 liter atmosphere. Of course, we need to change it to joule. So we multiply with 101.3 joule per liter atmosphere. Then we get the work done, which is equal to 2431.2 joule. And that is the work done from A to B process. B to C, the process B to C happen at constant volume. The volume does not change, is 9 liter. So that means that delta V is equal to zero, and the work done is equal to minus p delta v. That means if we replace delta v with 0, the work done will be equal to 0. So b to c, delta v is equal to 0, and the work done is equal to 0. Last step is c to a, and c to a, we have a decrease in pressure and decrease in volume. So then we know that the work done is equal to p dv minus p dv. Then this p, because the pressure has decreased, we need to do the average. It has decreased from 10 to 4, so we do the average between 10 plus 4 divided by 2 is equal to 7. Then the change in volume, it will be from 9 to 3. This means 3 minus 9. Then we get work done is equal to 42 liter atmosphere. Then we multiply with 103 joule per 100.3 joule per atmosphere to get 4254.6 joule as work done from C to A. Then the total work done, you need to add the first one, which is minus 2431.2 joule plus 0 for the B to C, plus 4254.6 joule from C to A. Then we get a total work done of 1823.4 joule as a total work done. And at an alternative to calculate the total work done, we can also calculate the total work done as the area under the curve. So if we can calculate the area under the curve, so the area under the curve, so the work done is the area under the curve. So we have a triangle and the area of the triangle, so we need to calculate the this base times the height, the base, which is the base here, times the height, which is here. So that means the change in the change in volume, 9 minus 3, times the change in the pressure, 10 minus 4. Then we can also use the area under the curve equal to the total work done. So the area under the curve, the area should be equal to 100, should be equal to area of the triangle, which is equal to 1 over 2 times b times h, the base times the height. So 1 over 2 times 6 coming from the base, which is 9 minus 3 is 6. Then times the height, which is 10 minus 4, we get 6. Then we get the total work done, which is liter atmosphere. So 36 over 2 is 18 liter atmosphere. Then we multiply with 100.3 joule per liter atmosphere to get the work done is equal to 1823.4 joule as the total work done. So we can also use the process. By process, we add a different work done from the process, or we can use the area under the curve. Let's go to question number 7. Question number 7 is asking how much work does the gas perform at constant pressure of 8.4 atmosphere as it expands from a volume of 2 to 4 atmosphere, which means there is an expansion. The delta V is equal to 4.5 minus 2. Then you have a constant atmosphere. So work done is equal to minus PdV minus PdV. Then we are replacing the constant pressure, which is 8.4 atmosphere. The change in volume from 4.5 minus 2 to 2. Then we have a minus 21 liter atmosphere. We change it to joule, because this 101.3 joule per liter atmosphere comes from dividing the R constant in joule per mole Kelvin, dividing for R constant in a liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin. Then you get 101.3 joule per liter atmosphere. So then we can convert 1 liter atmosphere is equal to 101.3 joule, then minus 21 liter atmosphere, minus 21 liter atmosphere will be equal to minus 21 liter atmosphere times 101.3 joule per liter atmosphere. Then you get minus 2127.3 joule of work. Of course, the work is negative since work flows out of the system. So there is a flow of work out of the system. And when the work is flowing from surrounding to the system, in that case, the work is positive. Of course, there's sign are conventional. So in some book of physics, you see that they use the reverse. They use work done equal to PdV. They don't put the negative sign. So in that case, you will see if you read some books in physics, their conversion of sign in physics and chemistry, they are different. So if you see, don't get confused once you see that they have used this as a positive to 127.3 joule. That means that you are reading the book in physics. The conversion of sign, conventional sign in books of chemistry and physics, they are somehow different. But the energy and work done is the same. Let's move to question 8. Calculate the work associated with the expansion of gas from 46 liter to 64 liter. So you have expansion, of course, the work, there is a flow of work from the system. That means that the work that we get will be positive, and it expands at external pressure, a constant external pressure of 415 atmosphere. That means that the pressure is constant. So here we use the formula to calculate work done is equal to minus PdV. The pressure was given. The change in volume of also is 64 liter minus 46 liter. Then we get 200 minus 270 liter atmosphere. Then we convert to joule by using the same scenario by multiplying with 101.3 liter per joule. 101.3 joule per liter atmosphere. Then we will get minus 2735. Minus 27,351 joule as the work. Work is negative since work flows out of the system as we have seen. Let's go to question number 9. Question number 9 is telling us that we have 4.5 moles of iodide gas is heated at constant pressure from 30 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Here we don't have the change in volume, but we are having the change in temperature from 30 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Calculate the work performed by this gas. So it's the same scenario, but we are not going to use a PdV. We are going to use minus NRDT because we have the change in the temperature. Then we replace the values, the change in temperature, we change it to Kelvin. Here we have changed the temperature from degree Celsius to Kelvin. Then we get minus 4489.83 joule of work. Question number 10, which is the last question of today. The pressure of the gas inside the rigid 2.4 cylinder, so the volume of the cylinder given, is decreased from 4.8 atmosphere to 3.8 atmosphere at constant volume. So here the volume is constant. How much work was done at or by the system? Here the question is very simple. So you know the work done is equal to minus PdV, and the volume is constant. And if the volume is constant, the delta V or the change in V is zero. That automatically means that if you are replacing zero here, delta V is zero. So the work done is also here zero. The volume is constant. The delta V is equal to zero. Work done is equal to zero. No work is done by or at the system.